filtering a data. In the last video, we have discussed about the means sorting the data and deleting the records in the last video. And today we are going to discuss about the filtering of data. Means that filtering data means the filter feature is one of the interesting feature of Excel, which helps you to display only those record that meets the specific criteria and the hides rest of records. It means that in the filter we can filter the those type of data which we want, or others data will be hidden. Here is the step how we can put the filter in your data. Select any cell within the data range, say D1, click on the filter button in the sorting and sort and filter the group in the data tab. A small error will be added in the column header. These arrows are used to specify the condition to filter data. And click on the arrow next to the Hindi column header in the cell D1. Uncheck the select all checkbox to deselect all the checkboxes. Now select the value A2 and 82 and 98 from the drop down list and click on OK button. You will notice that the list gets the filter display the only those record that meets the specified criteria, that is record related to the marks 82 and 98 marks. Here means that using a advanced filter, and now we can use the advanced filter to filter the data. Here we are going to discuss about how we can advanced filter option is used to filter the data multiple field using the specific criteria to copy the filter records to a different location or find the unique record. Let us use this option. Now insert at least 3 blank row above the range which is to be used as a criteria range by clicking on the home tab and selecting the insert and insert row option. After that, the criteria range must have column the labels which there should not be any blank row between the criteria value and the range. And now we are going to discuss about the insert the at least 3 row, okay, and the criteria range must be have the column level. There should not be any blank row between the criteria value and the range. Select the range A4 colon D4 and press Ctrl C to copy the range. Okay. After that, we are going to select the range A1 and B and Ctrl V. And after that, we put the value in there. And now you can see that the data in the this add action. Okay. After that, we are going to apply the this value, and now we can see the result is on the way. Okay. Now we are using the validation. This validation means what? This means put the some criteria means to access some rules to access the data. Means if you want to use the maximum minimum value to access the data from your sheets, then we can allow this type of validation also. Adding the subtotal in the database means how we can add the data in a database. Here we are going to discuss about that. The subtotal feature is the data helps to the manage, analyze and the extract the specific information from the row of related data. To apply subtotal, the data must be sorted. Let us learn the use of this feature through a given table. Follow the steps. Okay. This is the table. From this table, we are going to learn how we can do the subtotal. And after that, we are going to analyze the data down with the pivot table. Pivot table is a powerful tool to the consolidating the summarizing and the presenting the data. Follow this step to create the pivot table. Means pivot table, there we can summarize the data or analyze the data. It is the powerful tools. Okay, how we can prepare the pivot table? Enter the given data in the worksheet and select the entire data range and choose the insert option and pivot data. And there we can, now we can choose the pivot data. And now we can see the pivot data here. Option is given also there. Now we can see the this table in the pivot table layout. Okay. Now we are completed the this chapter, and in next chapter we will do the practical view how we can apply the these all topics whatever we have read. Okay, thank you.